If you're a content creator, you create a lot of large files. Sometimes you're trying to do a live stream or a Zoom meeting and you want to play a video. And that video is really heavy considering all the resources that your meeting or your live stream is using. And you might get some shaky, some glitchy, some skippy. And we want to solve that problem. I got a free tool that's going to absolutely blow your mind. Now, I've been using this tool forever. It's a well-known secret to video editors and people in the video space professionally. A lot of content creators don't know, but I'm going to hip you to this. And again, it's absolutely free. It is donationware. I highly suggest you donate to the creator because he's pretty awesome. But let me show you this real quick. This is a secret scroll, especially with those doing meetings or live streams. We're going to jump over to the browser, and I'm going to show you Shutter Encoder. This is the website, and what you're going to want to do is come over and press the download button, and the download button will take you to, you pick your machine. We are mostly on Apple Silicon, so you can do this, but it's been around so long, I even used it when it was an Intel version. But grab one of these, and here's your donation slider. You can make it whatever you feel is worth. You could even do zero, but you know, the creator makes his money like this, so give him at least a five spot. Anyway, let me show you how the app works. This is Shutter Encoder. What I'm going to do is take a video that I have on this machine, and it's just a video that I downloaded from Artlist, and it is, let me show you the file sizes. It sits right now at 2.92 gigabytes, and this is a 4K ProRes file. So that's a pretty large file. I'm going to drag this guy to Shutter Encoder, and all I want to do is press on this little down arrow, and then you're going to get this long list of things you could choose, and let's just choose H.265. I purposely choose H.265 on this machine because it's Apple Silicon, and we have special chips inside of our computer in order to make this work the best, right? And you can actually do multiple files, so if I wanted to drag in others, I could absolutely do that, right? I can do all of them at one time. That would just take too long. I've already done these two, so I'll show you what they look like while the first one's encoding. But you can add multiple files if you want. So if you have a bunch, you need to get ready for a stream. But here's the video. If you want to see what it looks like, you can give it a little play. So you can see it's good quality. Again, this is a ProRes file. And what I'm going to do is, without touching anything on this side, I'm going to go to this side. And where it says bitrate adjustment, right now it's set for variable bitrate. I don't really like that much. Click it once, click it twice until you see CQ. Now CQ, the lower the number, the better the quality of the video. The higher the number, the lower quality of the video. For what most of us need to do, I like to use 23, 24, sometimes 28 if there's not a lot of detail in the video, like landscape or something. But I normally select 24. That's my favorite. This doesn't really have audio, but if it did, I would normally select the audio at either 256. Occasionally, I'll set it for 320. Doesn't really need to go much more than that. And then that is it. The only thing you're going to touch is change this bitrate adjustment and use CQ. I find this to be the best. Even if you didn't touch much and you just pressed it without doing this, you will still get smaller files. But if you want smaller files, this is where you go. Okay? So again, put your file in. Hit the down arrow, select H.265. You can leave it on MP4. You can also make it MOV. It's completely up to you. Doesn't really change much. I don't know why people like to argue about that. And then change this till you see CQ24. And all you want to do is come over and press start. And it's going to start to make this file. Down here on the bottom, it's going to tell you how much time it's going to take, but it's thinking. And right now, on the very bottom, you see that it says it's going to take about 2 minutes and 43 seconds. So while that is going, I'm going to give you some previous examples that I did. So this one here is just a video that I posted a couple days ago. It was 3 gigs. The one right above it was 2.6 gigs. These are the after sizes. When I was done with the exact same settings that we just spoke of, I got the larger one down to 174.2, and the smaller one got down to 314.3. Now, you might say to yourself, why is there such a big difference considering the larger one? You would assume it creates a larger file. Well, while the other video is processing, let me explain this to you. I'm sitting here at a chair talking to you. The background isn't moving much. As a matter of fact, in that video, I don't have my background lights on. They're actually turned off. So if I turn those off with the Stream Deck button here, that means nothing back there is changing at all. So when the video is rendering, it only has to render my body and my hands. If I would stop talking with my hands and put them on the desk and talk like this, it will be even smaller because the only thing that's changing is basically my head, neck area, right? So when you flail, or you people who like to put tons of unnecessary animations in your videos, those are going to create larger files. But when the video has one section moving, it only has to render basically me. Everything else is stationary. It doesn't have to render that. And you can see, even in that video, it came out to a much smaller size. The other one that's bigger, it's a video where I'm outside. There's a bunch of cuts in there. I'm in different areas, different scenes, different levels of brightness. The colors are changing, so forth, so on, et cetera. So it generates a slightly larger file. Now, in the meantime, while we did that, we're over 72% done with the way Shutter Encoder is going to do this. And I was going to speed up the video, but no, I kind of want you to see this in real time, because in less than 3 minutes, we're going to take a video that was nearly 3 gigs, right? If we go back here to this other scene right here, that movie was 2.92 gigabytes, nearly 3 gigabytes. And when you see the size is going to come out, you're going to be mind blown. And the crazy thing about it, the quality, no one's going to see it once YouTube gets a hold of it. Or if you're live streaming, doing a Zoom meeting, a webinar, or something of that nature, no one's going to notice it, because that's going to get recompressed anyway by the platform. So what you want to do is limit how much resources your machine is using while this is happening. Now, here we go. It's at 100%. And that sucker is done. So let's click back over to the Finder and check out the size after. It came out to 68.1 megabytes. From 3 gigs to 68.1 megabytes. So now what I'm going to do is show you the before file and the after file. And in each of these examples, you'll be hard-pressed to see the differences between the original and the compressed version. Because, I mean, reality is, except for the ProRes version, which is the B-roll that I downloaded from Artlist, the other ones are already slightly compressed because when I rendered them in DaVinci or Final Cut, I forgot which one I edited them in, that already was compressed at some nature, but this is just taking that compression further. And we won't get heavy into encoders and, you know, codecs and all of that noise, but you can see from looking at these examples, once YouTube gets a hold of it, or your Zoom meeting, your webinar, whatever your conference platform is, maybe your website, no one's really going to notice the difference, and they're perfect for the use that we're using them for. We deliver client videos after they've been compressed with Shutter Encoder, and they're absolutely fine. You know what I say? I don't know who needs to hear this, but if it was you, let me know in the comment section below. Don't forget to go over and check out shutterencoder.com. Download this, give it a try. Again, you can do it for free, but if you use it, I highly suggest you donate, because this is a really incredible tool, something that I legit use every day. We won't even get into the part of converting things to WebM so you can have a transparent video with audio. That's a whole different video, but we'll come back to that. If you like this video, press the like button, press the subscribe button, ring the notification bell. And right about now, the algorithm is going to share another video that I think you should watch. And I agree with
him. I need to know everything. Who in the what and the where, I need everything. Trust me, I hear what you're saying, but act like it's new what you're telling me. I'm curious, George, I hop in the Porsche, a 5 and a horse, I'm ready for war, I'm coming for throws, to turn to a ghost, I need to know everything. Now you be surprised at the info you get, is by letting them talk, so I'm letting them talk. Gotta keep quiet, maneuver in silence, then let them in talk.